Hi everyone, so this is an overview of our paper with Bart Mennink named Type Preimage Resistance of the Sponge Construction. So we focus on the sponge used for hashing purposes based on the permutation. The sponge operates on a state of size bibits and it is split into two parts. The first one is called the outer part. It comprises orbits and it determines the rate at which message blocks are absorbed and the digest is extracted. Then we have the inner part. It comprises C bits, C is called the capacity, and this is a security parameter of the sponge. We will restrict ourselves to the case where the digest size is fixed to N bits, and we denote by L the number of required squeeze goal in order to extract the digest. There exist several tweaks to this construction, and here we focus on two of them which were introduced in the context of photon scheme. The first one allows to have a first message block which is larger, with a size denoted by R prime prime. And in the second tweak, the digest is extracted with a rate R prime, which is larger than R. Now we are interested by the provable security guarantees of the sponge. To do that, we place ourselves in the ideal primitive model, meaning that the permutation is assumed to be simple uniformly at random. Now, in order to argue that we have a good hash function, there are three classical security requirements, mainly preimage, second preimage, and collision resistance. Unfortunately, these security requirements are not strong enough for some applications. Consider, for example, the Merkle-Damgård construction based on an ideal compression function. Even if it is preimage, second preimage, and collision resistance, it is exposed to length extension attacks, which can be a problem in some concrete schemes. In fact, there exists a stronger security properties, which is called indifferentiability. In short, it is a distinguishing game where the adversary must differentiate between a random oracle and the construction based on a public primitive. It has been shown, among other, that indifferentiability implies security of preimage, second preimage, and collision. Now, going back to the sponge construction, it has been shown to be indifferentiable with a bound of form Q over 2 to the C over 2. Concretely, it tells us that in order to be able to differentiate the sponge from a random oracle, one needs at least 2 to the C over 2 queries. And below this number of queries, any attack on the sponge cannot be easier than the same attack on a random oracle. This is what we can see on this table, where for the classical security properties, the security bound is the sum of two terms. The first one comes from indifferentiability, while the second one is the success probability of a generic attack on a random oracle. Now we can compare the security bound against the best known attack. So for indifferentiability, collision, and second preimage, this is clear that the security bound matches the best known attack. And the non-generic part of the attack exploit in a collision of the sponge. And this is the key idea. Now for preimage, the best known attack is essentially the same one as second preimage, but there is an extra step, of course, 2 to the n minus r prime. This step was not required in the case of second preimage because the knowledge of one first preimage gave us access to intermediate state within the sponge, and it saved some work in the attack cost. On the other side, the security bound of second preimage and preimage are the same. Therefore, when the cost of this extra step is larger than the cost of finding in a collision, there is therefore a gap between the security bound and the best known attack. And in this work, we proved a tighter security bound for preimage resistance, which shows in particular optimality of the best known attack. In fact, this bound was already believed to be true, but there was no proof for that. Our bond can improve the state-of-the-art preimage security resistance of scheme that output the digest in multiple runs. And this is the case for some lightweight crypto scheme where we have small primitives and small rates. So on this table, we have several lightweight schemes and the comparison between the old security bond and the new security bond. A large part of these schemes are candidates of the NIST lightweight crypto competition. And in particular, there are two finalists, AsconHash and Photon Beetle Hash. For the case of AsconHash, the security bond shows an improvement of 50% in the exponents. So that's it for this presentation. I hope that you enjoy it, and thank you for your attention.